Well, welcome back to the show. Look, some exciting health news this morning. 3AW's Neil Mitchell and the Today Show here brought you the story, a new treatment dubbed the Future of Cancer Therapy. Well, it's just received the green light from the TGA.
Pretty incredible news. The Aussie scientists behind the therapy say it could result in 80% of cancers being curable within 2 or 3 decades.
Massive.
Extraordinary figures there. Let's bring in today medical expert Dr. Nick Coatsworth now. Now, Doc, this is being labelled a total shift in the way we treat cancer.
Oh, Sarah, I couldn't agree more. This is called CAR T-cell therapy. And remember the T-cells that were so important in fighting COVID? They're an important part of our immune system. CAR T-cell therapy allows us to take those T-cells from a patient with blood cancer, re-engineer them to recognise that cancer better, and then re-inject them so that it can assist with curing cancer, particularly in those individuals who have failed standard therapy. So these are people who really have no other option. And the most exciting news for myeloma patients today is that it's the Australian government that's now agreed to subsidise that treatment, which is significant. Significant cost to the patient.
Look, it has to be said too that Neil Mitchell raised this story only a couple of weeks ago,
yeah.
and it was on the front page of our papers as well as being on this show. It's moved pretty quick. That treatment was about $600,000 a treatment.
Yeah.
So now it's looking highly likely that it'll be more accessible to a wider section of the population, which is just incredible.
Yeah, it's great news, and undoubtedly the publicity helps. It's been under discussion for several years at the Pharmaceutical Benefits Advisory Committee. But there's a broader issue here, Carl and Sarah, which is for patients who suffer from rare diseases like untreatable multiple myeloma, this sort of approval gives hope that the government's looking to fund these. Now, of course, they're expensive on an individual level, but because there's not many of these patients, as an actual impact on the health system budget, it doesn't end up being enormous. So I think it's a good decision. It's the right decision. It's bringing a lot of hope to people around Australia today.
Yeah, absolutely. Very welcome news. Hey, Doc, let's move on to a different topic now. And about 1 in 2 Aussies are skipping important medical treatment because of the cost, given this rising cost of living crisis we're currently in. What impact is that having?
So this statistic came from the Australian Healthcare Index, from the Australian Patients Association, supported by Health Engine. We're going to talk about it on a webinar, actually, national webinar tomorrow. But I think what's going on here of particular concern is that in the 18 to 34-year-old age group, 1 in 2 people are looking at the cost of attending a general practitioner and saying, that's not for me. So cost is obviously an issue, but they're also looking at the value that that appointment's giving them, and they're not seeing value there. And so they're not going to the general practitioner. So we need to do two things. We need to decrease the cost, and the bulk billing incentive will go up in November. So let's see what happens there. But I think general practice as a whole needs to look at the value of what they're providing to young people in particular and make sure that they're prepared to pay for it.
Yeah, because otherwise there are consequences if they don't take up that those medical checks. Good on you, Doc. Always good to see you, and good luck with the webinar.
Webinar.
Debonair webinar with him.
Thanks, guys.